Namo Namaha students, hello. I am Ruchita and today in Sanskrit grammar, let us take a look at something very simple and yet interesting. We are looking at the use of Tvam and Bhavan. So let's understand the concept here. We have an example up here. If we were to say something like this, when we see our friend eating, we would ask, Tum kya kha rahe ho? Tu kai khat ahes? Or what are you eating? If we were to ask the same thing in Sanskrit, then we would address our friend or someone younger than us. We would say, Tvam kim khadasi? And if we were to address someone elderly and ask the same question, then we would ask, Aap kya kha rahe ho? Tumhi kai khat ahat? What is the respected one eating? Or in English, you would say, What are you eating? But in Sanskrit, you would say this same thing differently because you are addressing with respect and you would say, Bhavan kim khadati? So students, I'm sure you spotted that there are two different words that we use when we wish to show respect to people. If a person is our age, we say Tvam. If the person is older than us or respectable, we say Bhavan. So here students, we can say that while changing Tvam to Bhavan, you can see Tvam has changed to Bhavan, the Kriyapada Khadasi has changed to Khadati. Let us say, to be very, very specific, it is the different pratyaya that we are using. So, Tvam Khadasi and Bhavan Khadati. Well, let's understand this better. Why does this change take place? So, let's take a look at what is Tvam. When we say Tvam, what we are actually saying is you. Because Tvam means you. Now, this is used for a friend or a person who is younger with whom you speak informally. It is the ekavachan of the dvitiya purush sarvanam yushmad. Remember, because the karta is dvitiya purush ekavachan, therefore the kriyapada also used with it has to be dvitiya purush ekavachan. Tvam khadasi, remember? Now, you can use this in any kala or artha. Let's take an example. If we have the subject tvam, then for a parasmaipadi dhatu in vartaman kala, let us say, Gamagachha, which means go, you would say Tvam gachhasi, which means you are going. If you were to say this in Prathama Bhutakal, that is your past tense, you would say Tvam agachhah, which means you went. If you wanted to give an order or a command or a request in Adnyartha, that is imperative mood, you would say Tvam gachha, you go. And if you were to, you could also say this as you may go. If you were to say this in Vidyartha, where you are trying to indicate that it's necessary or you should go, then in that case you would say Tvam gachhehe, and the meaning of this would be you should go. Let's see the same thing. If we were to use an Atmanepada dhatu, then for an Atmanepada dhatu like Ram, which means to enjoy, you would say Tvam ramase, which means you are enjoying. In past tense, in Prathama Bhutakal, you would say Tvam aramathaha, which means you enjoyed. And if you were to say this in Adnyartha, giving order, request or a permission, then you would say Tvam ramasva, which means you may enjoy. And if you were to say this in Vidyartha, saying you should enjoy, then you would say Tvam ramethaha, which means you should enjoy. So you can see, students, here, that with Tvam, we have used different pratyayas depending on the tense. Tvam gachhasi, Tvam agachhah, Tvam gachha, Tvam gachhehe. And if it was Atmanepada, then Tvam ramase, Tvam aramathaha, Tvam ramasva, and Tvam ramethaha. Let us see what happens with Bhavan. If we were to take Bhavan, then the meaning of Bhavan means you, but the respected one. Now, this is used for a person who is respected or older than us. And it is the ekavachan form of the Tritiya Purush Sarvanam Bhavat. So, Bhavan comes from the Sarvanam Bhavat, which is a Tritiya Purush Sarvanam. You will see that because the Karta is Tritiya Purush Ekavachan, the Kriyapada also has to be Tritiya Purush Ekavachan. And hence, you will see its usage in any Kala or Artha as follows. Like we have seen for Tvam, let's see it for Bhavan. So for Bhavan, you will see in the Parasmaipad Dhatu like Gamagachha, you will see for Vartamana Kala, it is Bhavan Gachati, which means the respected one is going. For Prathama Bhutakala, you will see it is Bhavan Agachat, which means the respected one went. If it is imperative mood, that is Adnyartha, then you would say Bhavan Gachatu, which will mean may the respected one go. And if it is Vidyartha, which is potential mood, which means you, which means to say Bhavan Gachet, that is the respected one should go, you would have these sentences. If the dhatu was Atmanepada, just like we took there earlier, Ram, then in that case, you will see for the Atmanepada dhatu, it is Bhavan Ramate, which means the respected one is enjoying. In Prathama Bhutakal, it is Bhavan Aramata, which means the respected one enjoyed. And if it is Adnyartha, that is giving order, request, permission, then in that case, it will be Bhavan Ramatam, which means to say the respected one may enjoy. And if it is Vidyartha, that is potential, to say the respected one should enjoy, it would be Bhavan Rameta. So, the respected one should enjoy. Now, these are the different forms that we have seen. So, for Bhavan, you have Bhavan Gachati, Bhavan Agachat, Bhavan Gachatu, Bhavan Gachet. It could be Bhavan Ramate, Bhavan Aramata, Bhavan Ramatam, and Bhavan Rameta. Well, students, what we have seen over here are different sentences for Tvam and Bhavan. Let us take a look at the endings of the Kala or the Artha used for Tvam and Bhavan on a comparative status.